Hola a todos. Thank you so much for being here today. Finally, we are arriving to the end of our journey through the music of Latin America. Today we are going to go visit Guatemala, Mexico, Cuba, Dominican Republic, and Puerto Rico. Today is kind of a bittersweet moment for me. I've been working really hard for the past month to bring you these videos, to give you just a little hint, a little taste of what is the culture of Latin America. If you notice in the past video, I like surprises and I invited a friend to play with us. Well, this time I brought a lot of friends. We all belong to La Formula Music Productions, a huge family of artists that precisely are looking forward to teach and to bring to people more about the Latin American culture and the world culture in general. So I want to say to you guys, members of La Formula, thank you so much for this hard work. And for the rest of you, please enjoy this concert. It has been really hard work and we are doing it with all the love. Thank you for everything that you've done. Of course, thank you so much to Amy Carroll and Campbell County Public Library for having us here. Thank you to the patrons. And well, let's enjoy today our last episode. Thank you.
Okay, buenas noches a todos. Bueno, hoy vamos a comenzar con este país, Guatemala. Y tengo unos invitados muy especiales. Ellos son estudiantes míos, viven aquí en Cincinnati y todos ellos vienen desde Guatemala. Pero no voy a ser yo quien los presente, ellos se van a presentar a sí mismos. Entonces, comencemos con Axel, cuéntanos.
Hola a todos, yo soy Axel Juárez y soy alumno de Óscar. Actualmente estoy aprendiendo a tocar la batería.
Perfecto. Cuéntanos, Dani.
Hola a todos, yo me llamo Dani Juárez y yo toco la guitarra y soy estudiante de Óscar también.
Y por último, Raulito.
Hola, ¿cómo están? Saludos. Buenas noches, buenas tardes, buenos días. Mi nombre es Raúl Juárez. Soy el estudiante de Óscar también.
¿Qué instrumento toca, Raúl?
Estoy tocando el saxofón alto.
Saxofón alto. Bueno.
Sí.
Si se dan cuenta, todos son de apellido Juárez. Son familia. ¿Quiénes son familia?
Sí, es.
Son primos y hermanos, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Listo. Bueno, pues estoy muy contento de tenerlos acá. Ellos son muy especiales. Son estudiantes míos ya desde hace 2 años. Y cuando estábamos comenzando este proyecto sobre Latinoamérica, pues quería hablar así un poco más cerca de, y dar a conocer las culturas que conforman los países de Latinoamérica. Afortunadamente, pues conozco gente de Guatemala y qué mejor que ellos que nos expliquen acerca de esto. Cuéntanos, Raúl, ¿cuánto tiempo llevan aquí?
Yo llevo 4 años estar aquí en Cincinnati.
Bueno, y Axel, ¿es muy grande la comunidad de personas de Guatemala aquí en Cincinnati?
Sí, son bastantes las personas de Guatemala. Lo que he visto es en cada lugar donde tú vas, siempre hay personas que son de Guatemala y son muchísimos. Nosotros acudimos a una comunidad que es de aproximadamente de 300, 400 personas, pero existen más comunidades, hablando de parroquias y existen más comunidades que acuden casi la misma cantidad de personas, pero no contando las personas que van en otros lugares, que van incluso personas que no asistan a ninguna comunidad como donde nosotros estamos acudiendo. Pero sí, hay una buena cantidad de personas que son de Guatemala en Cincinnati.
Y creo que Cincinnati es de las ciudades que más personas de Guatemala tiene y también creo que es la mayor congregación de latinos que hay en Cincinnati, los guatemaltecas. Dani, cuéntame, ¿qué es lo que más extrañas de Guatemala?
Los lugares ahí, las costumbres que hacemos ahí, unos lugares y Y sí, unas fiestas ahí que nosotros hacemos culturales. Uh-huh. Fiestas puro culturales. Eso es lo que
más hace
un
falta.
Poco todo. La comida también. Comida chapín.
La comida chapín. Ok, ¿y qué significa chapín? Sí. ¿O se le dice a todos los guatemaltecas, se les dice chapines?
Sí.
Eso es nuevo. Para mí eso es nuevo. Pero bueno. ¿Tú qué extrañas, Raúl?
Igual, Oscar. Extraño mi pueblo, mi aldea. Extraño Concepción Chiquitichapa. Ya sabes, donde hay culturas, se ve todo, en todos lados.
Bueno, algo muy particular que me interesa aquí es Guatemala, sí hablan español, pero también hablan muchísimas lenguas indígenas. Y entre esas es la lengua de ustedes, que es el MAM, ¿correcto?
Sí, así es.
De hecho, se me olvidó preguntar, ¿cómo saludan ustedes? Cuéntame, Raúl, ¿cómo saludan ustedes en MAM?
Por ejemplo, si ves una persona, ¿cómo estás? Sentaya.
Sentaya.
Sí.
Ahí voy aprendiendo de a poquito, sin afanes. ¿Sí o no? Bueno, y hay muchísimos dialectos, ¿no? De hecho, hay comunidades cercanas que tienen diferentes dialectos similares, pero pues no son lo mismo. Se habla parecido, pero no es lo mismo, ¿correcto?
Sí, como por ejemplo... San Juan Oxtucalco y Concepción Chiquilchapa. Bueno, es el mismo dialecto MAM, pero hay un poco de diferencia.
Ok, es decir, si por ejemplo escuchamos personas hablando en portugués y en español, hay varias palabras que se parecen, pero pues no todo es igual, ¿correcto? Igual en capítulos anteriores nosotros hablamos de por ejemplo, el lenguaje quichua y quechua, que no son lo mismo. Entonces son lenguajes que tienen construcciones similares, pero que tienen palabras diferentes. Vamos a hablar un poquito de música, sí, porque sí. Eso es lo que vinimos a hacer hoy. Entonces, Axel, cuéntame, ¿qué es la música más común de Guatemala?
Bueno, los más tradicionales son, por ejemplo, los que son tocados con marimba, por ejemplo, el son, el rey quiché, que es uno de los más grandes sones que existen allá en Guatemala. Y también uno que nosotros tenemos ahí, nosotros somos de un departamento que es Quetzaltenango, es del sur occidente de Guatemala. Entonces, también Luna de Xelajú es una música que se canta mucho ahí. Entonces, ¿qué? Tradicionalmente siempre se toca con la marimba, es lo más tradicional.
Y ahora que estás hablando de la marimba, quiero darle un saludo muy especial a nuestro marimbero, a la persona que tocó marimba con nosotros hoy, que se llama Ryan Jones. Un saludo para Ryan. Thank you so much for this participation of you here. It's not the only song that he's playing today, but thank you so much because the marimba gave it a really special sound and it sounds actually like Guatemalan music. So I'm really glad that you join us. Dani, cuéntanos, ¿cómo fue tu experiencia grabando?
La verdad, sí, fue un poco difícil, pero como es la primera vez que he grabado un proyecto así, pero sí, sí se pudo, con un poco de esfuerzo, pero sí se pudo.
Bastante esfuerzo, y de hecho lo van a escuchar, muy buen trabajo el de estos muchachos. ¿Cómo fue la experiencia para ti, Raúl?
Es una experiencia maravillosa que he tenido por primera vez y siempre he anhelado estar así en una grabación. Bueno, yo veo videos de otros muchachos y me gustaría hacer lo que ellos hacen. Pero ahora, gracias a Dios, que digamos que se cumplió mi sueño, ¿no? Y gracias, Oscar, de verdad, gracias por la invitación también. Estoy muy, muy feliz, en serio, muy feliz.
Me alegra mucho porque pues este es el comienzo de varios proyectos, ¿cierto? Vamos a hacer más proyectos y, y la idea es precisamente que las personas empiecen a entender más de nuestras culturas. Afortunadamente, pues hoy hay tecnología para hacer todas estas cosas. Entonces, junto a la tecnología y de buen trabajo, trabajo fuerte, ustedes se dieron cuenta que esto es trabajo fuerte, vamos a seguir haciéndolo. Cuéntanos, Axel, ¿cómo te sentiste?
Pues la verdad, un poco... muy bien, la verdad, este, como dice Raúl, es dar un agradecimiento a usted que tú nos has ayudado nos has tenido la confianza para poder hacer este proyecto. Y también me he sentido muy, muy bien porque es uno de los, por ejemplo, uno de los materiales que hicimos, es una música, un canto que a mí me gusta, especialmente porque nosotros allá en nuestro departamento tenemos un equipo de fútbol que se llama Xelajú y soy muy fanático de eso. Y ese es uno de los himnos que se cantan ahí en los estadios, me gusta escucharlo. Y también una de las experiencias que tuve es que yo no soy mucho de cantar, pero hoy intenté cantar con lo que pude y sí me emocioné mucho y estoy muy contento por eso.
Qué bien, y esa es la idea, que cada vez que hagamos algo nuevo pues nos enriquezca y no sé, nos llene de nuevas experiencias. Bueno, entonces muchachos, llegó la hora de tocar. Vamos a escuchar qué fue lo que hicimos. Muchísimas gracias, en serio, quiero felicitarlos porque ustedes han hecho un trabajo espectacular con esto. Eso requiere mucho esfuerzo, mucha paciencia. Entonces los quiero felicitar por eso. Bueno, cuéntame, Raulito, ¿cuál es la siguiente canción?
Pues aquí les presentamos nada más y nada menos Luna de Xelajú en mam y en español.
Perfecto.
Es dedicada para todos Xela. Para los que son de Xela, pues saludos.
A todos los de Xela. Y de hecho, quisiera, antes de que nos vayamos, Dani, ¿qué quisieras decirle tú a estos artistas nuevos latinoamericanos que están comenzando, que están haciendo nuevos proyectos? ¿Qué quisieras decirles?
Ah, pues que trabajen muy duro para hacer un proyecto así. Tienen que estudiar también, estudiar la música para más entender más fácil. Pero si no estudias, es un poco más difícil. Como nosotros ya estudiamos contigo, ya más o menos ya entendemos cómo leer la partitura, todo eso. Y entonces nos hizo un poco fácil.
Bueno. Compartir que amigos y familiares, pues por primera vez vamos a grabarle a tu maestro Óscar de música. Él es colombiano. Gracias, Óscar. Chonte, Óscar. Gracias, chonte.
Chonte. Ok, buenas noches, muchachos. Muchas gracias.
Adiós.
Chao, chao.
Hasta la próxima.
Magic, 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 magic
Really fun to be here in Guatemala. And now we're going to our next country. And for that, we have a really special guest. He's one of my best friends. And he lives here in the city in Cincinnati, but I'm not going to be who introduced him. Who are you?
Tino. My name is Tino, Tino Barbosa.
Well, and what did you do?
I'm an entrepreneur. I have a couple of businesses. I've been here in Cincinnati for 30 years, and that's what I do.
So I know you are one of the first Latinos to arrive here to the city.
Probably. I mean, there were a few, but yeah. I've been here 30-something years, 31 years in Cincinnati.
Wow. Have you seen changes in the Latino community since then?
Oh, yes, many, many changes, huge.
Yeah.
Huge.
Well, how long have you been doing music?
Well, you know that I couldn't call myself a musician, although I love music, and I have played with some terrific musicians, as yourself, with really, really good musicians, but I've been in different bands here in Cincinnati since I've arrived. I live in Florida too, and I used to play just for fun with friends down there. I start hanging with the Cubans, and you know how that is.
I know how that is.
You hang with the Cubans, and then you start getting that love for that music.
Yeah. Yeah. Later today, we're going to talk about the Cuban music too. Well,
awesome.
Yes, so tell us about Mexico. We're going to your land today, and we actually choose a really beautiful song, but before that, tell us, what do you miss the most?
I miss the most the food. The food, specifically my grandmother's. Mm-hmm. My grandmother's food, my mom's. But if I have to be honest, you know, I love my mom, but nobody beats my grandmother on. When it comes to cooking, she's just amazing. And that's what I miss the most. I miss a lot of friends and family. But after 30 years, you know, you start getting used to to be here, and I go quite often. I go once or twice a year and visit people, and just it's a wonderful country. Mexico is a really wonderful country. It's marvelous. It got too much history, too much culture, too many things to offer. Very, very, very beautiful country.
And because we came here today to do music, tell us a little bit about the Mexican music.
Wow, Mexican music. Well, just so I don't bore you, because you could spend days with Mexican music. Because you know, Mexican music is like a lot about races. It's like a hybrid, or like a mestizaje, what we call, of like the different cultures. The Spanish brought a lot of like instruments. In Mexico, pre-Hispanic, there were some beautiful music made with flutes and some percussion and stuff. But then the strings and the metal, the trumpets were brought by the Spaniards, like so many different things. And then the Spaniards, you know, as you know, they have influence from other countries, from Arabs, from Africa, from all over. Then when they mixed with the Mexicans, so many beautiful waves, new waves of music start, like in other countries, like in Colombia or Cuba, like that. But in Mexico, the most important, I think, it was the mariachi music. And that's probably what we're going to do today, or we're going to talk about today. And the mariachi music is just so vast, so powerful, so meaningful, so soulful. The lyrics, the passion, it's popular music, but it's beautiful music. It's very intricate, very elaborate. It's well renowned all over the world. Everybody, I mean, there is mariachi bands in Japan, in Holland, in Germany. And I'm not talking Mexican bands. It's like the Japanese mariachis or German mariachis or Holland mariachis. It's beautiful. It's very passionate and powerful.
Well, and actually you belong now to the first Cincinnatian mariachi.
That's right. Thanks to you. I've been telling you, let's do it. Let's do it. I've been telling you for 5 years, and just finally you listen.
It's happening. It's happening, finally. Well, how was your experience recording?
With you in this particular recording, it was wonderful. I mean, I'm very happy and I'm very proud of you. You know that I always say people that how talented you are. You are a very, very talented young guy, and I'm very proud to be your friend, because you know what you're doing. It's very nice. It's very easy to work with you. It's cool. You are very patient. You have a gift, which is like, you know how to work with musicians, which is, it's a good thing.
I think it's good. Because we are gonna see a good result of this, and our intention is just to put a lot of musicians doing beautiful things together.
Well, yeah, it's I think it's gonna sound really good. Everything that you do, you're kind of like the King Midas of music. You touch something and turn it into really something really good.
Thank you, my friend. And so what would you like to say to the people from the area and whoever is watching us right now about Latinos and about how to approach our communities and our culture?
Well, right now, you know, there has to be, in these times of like going all this year that has been just so crazy, we need a lot of like love and tolerance. And that's what I've been trying to do since I got here. I've been trying to create a community where everybody can interact and help each other. You know, like if you're a musician, you need something, and there is a plumber, a carpenter, well, we all, a mechanic, whatever profession we do, just start like creating a community where we can help each other. And to a certain point, I think we have done it. We have created, you know, certain unity in the community. And we just have to grow together, forget about, you know, all that envy stuff, and just, yeah, being like in a brotherhood, sisterhood, you know, we all just have to walk together. and try to see whoever needs some a little push or help. Well, to be there for them. Because it's a beautiful community. The Latin community is a beautiful community. It brings a lot of, exactly like you mentioned, a lot of color, a lot of culture, a lot of history, a lot of diversity, which includes all kinds of things, all the things that I mentioned, plus happiness, love, dancing, singing, all of this stuff, which is beautiful from all Latin America. I mean, every country in Latin America has very, very specific and very beautiful things to offer. I think it's a marvelous thing to be in a Latino.
Would you like to introduce us to our next song?
Oh yeah, next song, it's called Mexico Lindo y Querido, and it's one of the more representatives of that country of Mexico. Is for so many people, it's like a second anthem. It's a song that talks about, you know, about how beautiful the land is, and if you ever will die far away from Mexico, you would like to tell people, everybody, you know, that you're just sleeping, that you're not dead, that just bring me back to Mexico, because that's what I want to do.
That's beautiful. Thank you so much, Tino, and let's go make some music.
All right. Thank you, Oscar. Thank you. I want to thank you again. I love you. You are a very talented guy. Thank you so much for what you're doing musically here in this town. I think we needed it. We needed it, you, for a long time. So I'm so glad that you're here now.
Thank you. And part of that
beautiful music.
Part
beautiful
of that reason music. is because of you too. So thank you so much. I love you, my friend. And let's enjoy.
All right. Thanks
ciao, ciao.
A lot. And thanks to everybody. Thank you. Blessings.
De la guitarra mía, al despertar en la mañana, quiero cantar la alegría de mi tierra mexicana. Yo le canto a sus volcanes, a sus praderas y flores, que son como talismanes del amor de mis amores. México lindo y querido, si muero lejos de ti, que digan que estoy dormido y que me traigan aquí. Digan que estoy dormido y que me traigan aquí. México lindo y querido, si muero lejos de ti. Que me entierren en la sierra, al pie de los magallanes, y que me cubra esa tierra, es una de hombres cabales. Voz de la guitarra mía, al despertar la mañana, quiero cantar la alegría tierra mexicana.
México lindo y querido, si puedo lejos de aquí,
que digan que estoy dormido y que me traigan aquí,
digan que soy dormido
y que me traigan aquí. México lindo y querido,
si fuero
Cuba has a really important and dear place in my heart. When I was very young, around 10, 11 years old, I started to discover a lot of the Latin American artists particularly, but one of the biggest artists that caused a huge impact in my life, not just as a musician, but as a person, was Silvio Rodriguez from Cuba. And they create all this movement of Nueva Trova back in the 60s, 70s. And what it caused a big impression on me was the sensitivity of its lyrics, of its poetry, the quality of it, not only from the literary part, but also from the musical part. And through Silvio Rodriguez, I started to discover a lot of different bands, musicians, styles, genres, because the richness of Cuban music is, well, is there. So thanks to that, I started to discover Pablo Milanes, I started to discover even Afro-Cuba, or one of the greatest, if and the creators of timba and Latin jazz, Irakere. So there are no words to explain how rich and how beautiful is the culture, and particularly not only the music culture, but also arts in general in Cuba. So I think this is a little homage and a little hint of respect for a little show of respect for what Cuba represents to me. Thank you so much. From Silvio Rodriguez, Bendita. Y fuente bendita,
el cielo. Yo fui una vez sin sonte, yo fui una vez lo nuevo. El cielo y monte, bendita, bendita aquella vez, bendita, bendita aquella vez.
Okay, everyone. Hello. Well, our next guest here is Catherine. Hi, how are you, Catherine?
Hi, I'm doing good. How are you?
Excellent. We are really excited to have you here tonight. Fortunately, in this last episode of the Music of Latin America, we could invite some of the local artists. We are lucky enough to have artists to talk about their countries. So, who is better to talk about Dominican Republic than you? Okay.
So I thank you so know. Much. Thank you.
Yeah. Well, tell us a little bit about yourself. Who are you, Catherine?
So, I am Catherine, of course, and I am from the Dominican Republic, specifically from Santiago, which is considered the heart city because it's kind of in the middle of the country.
Okay.
It's the second largest city of the Dominican Republic. I've been here in the United States for 10 years. I actually had my 10-year anniversary living here in this country past May.
Wow, congratulations.
Thank you. Yeah. And I actually sing in a Latino band here in Cincinnati, but... professionally, I work in human resources for an American company. So, yeah, kind of different paths in life.
True. You know, like that you can do both and still do art and bring a little bit about our Latino culture. Because this is precisely what this is about. Like to share and to communicate the many rich colors and flavors and everything that we are as Latinos. Well, tell me, what do you miss the most?
Oh my God. The culture, of course. Dominican people are very warm. My friends, the beaches, the weather, the food, of course.
Yeah.
So yeah, I do mean a lot of things from out there. That's for sure. Yeah,
I understand you, and well, now we are at home in Cincinnati.
Yeah, it is nice. It is nice living here. I mean, I go back to the Dominican Republic, I will say, every 2-3 years. Mm-hmm. And every time I go, you just have the sense that something changed in a good way, I will say. But the essence of the country is still there. So, mm-hmm. Yeah, I still visit the same places that I used to go when I used to live there, because it's just the things that bring good memories. Yeah.
That's great. And mm-hmm. Well, you did music, like you do music here, you did also music professionally there.
I did, yes. So let me tell you a little bit about my story in music. So I started singing since I was a kid, but it was just joking around. You know, my dad used to sing, my grandfather used to sing, but I never took it serious, I will say. It was more like I will grab a brush, a hairbrush, and then I will start singing in the living room or something like that. But then when I was in high school, I remember for graduation, we just put a group together. It was just a couple of friends, girls all, and we sang on the day of our graduation. And from there, it just everything started. So I was singing when I was in college. I actually got half scholarship from singing, as part of the band in college, and then I was singing in the city. I sang in Punta Cana, which is, you know, it's a famous part of the Dominican Republic, in Santo Domingo, which is the capital, I was singing Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. I used to sing in restaurants, casinos, private parties like weddings, birthday parties and things like that. So yeah, music is a essential part of my life. So when I moved here to the States, I thought that by living in Cincinnati, I wasn't gonna have the opportunity to continue with my passion, which is singing music. But yeah, I fortunately had the opportunity to be part of a band, and I'm constantly singing. Even if I wasn't part of that band, I was singing at home with friends. Music is just an essential part of my life, I will say. Yeah.
And I think lately we have realized that it's also an essential part of non-musicians. And that is why mm-hmm. we're doing all this kind of stuff, you know, like everyone's looking for it. And it's great because we can share this that we do by passion, by love. Mm-hmm. Like everyone right now is like enjoying and seeing the need of it, especially to take care of our mental health.
Well,
how's the music in Republica?
So the traditional, I would say, popular music in the Dominican Republic is merengue and bachata. There's a lot of comments that with new music, new generation of music, I would say, like dembow, reggaeton, rap, the merengue and bachata was gonna disappear. That's what everybody was just so scared about that. But I don't think that will never happen. I mean, merengue, bachata is the music that represent us. And a lot of people from other part of the world, from other part of the world will know as soon as they hear a good merengue that that's from the Dominican Republic. I love singing merengue. I love the feeling of dancing merengue. I love bachata, even though, let me tell you, bachata back in the day used to be the music that was kind of ghetto, I would say, like the music that nobody wanted to hear.
Yeah.
Until Juan Luis Guerra actually kind of changed the color of bachata and made it more of a classic and more welcome music for everybody. And now, I don't think you can say you're Dominican if you don't know how to dance a good merengue or a good bachata.
Yeah.
Well, that's just part of us.
Now that you mention him, we're going to talk about Juan Luis. I think for me, and in Latin America, I think he's one of the greatest musicians. In general, I mean, I'm speaking for all the countries of Latin America. I think he's one of the most complete and that have achieved that universal goal of representing a country and a community as the Latinos itself, because he also plays in other kind of music related to the Caribbean. So why this song? When I asked you, hey, what song do you want to sing? And you told me this song.
Why this? Yeah. Well, when you contacted me, I was very honored when you said that you wanted me to be part of these representing my country. And of course, I needed to find somebody that it's not only known in the Dominican Republic. I wanted to sing a song of somebody that, like you said, is well known, I will say around the world, because Juan Luis Guerra has sung in Paris, in Amsterdam. So you know what I mean? In Japan, in countries that are no Latinos. They I don't know, they don't know anything probably about Latino culture, and they dance his music. So I knew it, like it was just, okay, it has to be a song from Juan Luis Guerra, it has to be a bachata, and what's better than this one that is, he just sings to love, and I think, I don't know, I like it, I really like that song, yeah.
Well, as you notice, Latinos are romantic.
Yep.
Well, how was your experience recording this?
It was good. You know, I was just getting familiar with, of course, this is a song that is kind of like, you know, everybody knows this song. As soon as somebody play this song and you're Dominican or you're Latino, you're going to start dancing or you're going to start, you know, singing this song. But then it was a good experience because I get to find out that some of the lyrics that I thought it was a way, it was a different way. So it was a good experience. It just brought very good memories. Yeah.
Well, so wait, enough of our review. Do you want to introduce us to the next song? You can do it in Spanish, everyone.
Okay, pues, con ustedes. Can I do it in Spanglish?
Por favor.
Con ustedes, one of the songs that I most love from Juan Luis Guerra, un cantante dominicano que hizo su release de este álbum en que esta canción estaba incluida on December 11, 1990. So let's enjoy this awesome bachata. Let's put some steps and let's dance.
Dance. Okay. Burbujas de amor. Muchísimas gracias, Caterine. Chao, chao.
Gracias. Chao.
Tengo un corazón lado de esperanza y de razón. Tengo un corazón que no atrapa su cordura. Ay, 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 este corazón se desnuda de impaciencia ante tu voz. Pobre corazón que no atrapa su cordura. Quisiera ser un pez para tu hacer burbujas de amor por donde quiera. De impaciencia ante tu voz. Pobre corazón que no atrapa su cordura. Quisiera ser un pez para tu
hacer burbujas de amor por donde quieran. Hacer siluetas de amor bajo la luna.
Oh, saciar esta locura mojado en ti.
Well, before we say goodbye, I really want to say thank you for being here, for appreciate this work, and to join us in the journey through the music of Latin America. It has been a pleasure, it has been a lot of hard work. If you notice, from the beginning I started working by myself, writing the music, doing the research, playing the music, recording, editing. And for this last video, I had a wonderful team, a wonderful family that gave their best to help us to bring this little project, very precious project. So thank you so much. Thank you to the members of La Formula Music Production. I wouldn't be able to do any of this without your help. So thank you so much. Of course, thank you to Amy Carroll and the veterans of Campbell County Public Library. We wouldn't be able to do this without you either. Thank you so much. Please don't forget to share, don't forget to subscribe, to visit our pages in Facebook, our YouTube channel, and also our, if you want and you are interested on helping and supporting these projects of showing the culture, you can also support us in our Patreon page. So let's enjoy our last country. Vámonos para Puerto Rico.
Hello everyone. Well, we are closing our series of concerts here today, and I think for me it's very special this, because we say at the beginning, Puerto Rico, even though it's not considered a country itself, we feel it as a country, as our sibling, you know, like our brother country. And I'm here with two of my best friends, actually, and they are from this beautiful country, Puerto Rico. Hello, everyone. ¿Cómo están?
Hello.
Okay, well, let's do a brief introduction. Tell us, Daryl, where are you?
I'm well. How are you, Oscar?
Excellent. Tell us a little bit more about you.
Okay, so I was born and raised in Puerto Rico. I've been living here in the state of Ohio for the last 6 years. In Puerto Rico, I did a lot of stuff. I had a bunch of jobs besides being a student as well. But I've been a musician since I was 4 years old, straight from church and then till today.
Yeah, that's great. What about you, Jaime?
Hello. Oh, hello. Well, I was born and raised in Puerto Rico, but I came to United States after high school, so I did my college year. Here I went to Indiana University and Cincinnati College Conservatory. I've been in Cincinnati for the past 27 years. Yeah, I've been musicians all my life, so I'm not only I perform, I teach, I conduct, you know, so, but music is my life, so that's what I do.
Yeah, and I'm really fortunate. I want to thank you, and I want to thank all the musicians that came to this special episode, because it was a really hard work in short time. So I think you guys will appreciate that a bit more. You know how hard it is to do this, but it's less hard to do it with good friends and with good company. So thank you so much for that. Well, we're going to talk a little bit about Puerto Rico before we go to our last song. Tell us a little bit more about the music of Puerto Rico. Jaime, what is the most popular music in Puerto Rico?
Well, that depends the time frame that we're talking about. But, you know, we create, I think, many composers in Puerto Rico of popular music. You know, I'm talking about popular music, like you know, like coming from early 20th century, like Pedro Flores, Rafael Hernandez, and one of the great composers, I believe, Bobby Capó. You know, they create this type of different sound that they sound like, maybe because the harmonies and the rhythm that they use. But, you know, it comes from Latin America, so we will have from boleros to guaracha, something like that. Plus, we have our own typical music that, you know, is more folkloric music, but we can talk about that later. But I think we want to show what become more international music, as you know, from bolero, salsa, you know, plena, bomba, up to nowadays reggaeton, you know. It's a big, huge mix, you know. It's like when you're talking about Puerto Rican music, is even it's huge. So, you know, it's the same when they ask me, can you talk about Latin American music? So it's so vast. I mean, it's like incredible.
Yeah. Well, and there is also like this campesino music, yeah, or country music that is actually very, very fundamental and very attached to all Puerto Rican hearts. How is it called, you, Daryl?
Well, we tend to improvise on décima, which is a poetry form that it's available all through Latin America, but in Puerto Rico, we sing it, and we sing it in many different styles. We have seis, and we have what we call aguinaldos, and all kinds of décima. But that's the music from our countryside. That's our inheritance from Spain, mixed with our Taino heritage as well. It's beautiful music.
Well, how was your experience, Jaime, recording with these musicians?
Oh, always it's a great experience, I have to tell you, because something new, always recording farther away from everybody, you know. Usually we make music together. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, it's a challenge, but at the same time, as you say, it's great to make music with friends, you know, and that's why we are musicians. Musicians are a special kind of people. It's a person that can work by itself, but at the same time, have to learn how to play with other people. I mean, we don't make music by yourself. We share our talent with other people to make great music. So for me, it was a great experience, you know, something new with this situation and everything. We have to learn ways and express ourselves in different ways. So it was great.
Oh, and you both recorded not only this song, but also a song from Cuba. And they also play a song from Dominican Republic. So we have this opportunity to get into other countries of Latin America as well. And you, Daryl, tell me, did you enjoy playing all these different songs?
It's a lot of fun. Yeah, it was a lot of fun. Still music that I grew up around, you know. Dominican music, you know, merengue and bachata. It's what was playing on Saturdays while mom was cleaning all around the house. So, you know, it's right there in my blood. Yes,
sir. Same here. Hello to all the moms and dads. Thank you so much. You know, yeah, well, Daryl, do you have any message to any artists from Latin America that you want to share and to encourage them?
Definitely. If there's something that I've learned, especially during this whole pandemic, is that you know, the internet is a great tool, you know, and I found that we can come together through the internet and do great things. And this project that Oscar is doing right now is a great example of it. It's given me many ideas and stuff that I want to do moving forward. And yeah, it's great. So my advice would be, don't be afraid, get yourself in front of a camera, put your music out there, and keep trying.
Jaime, what would you like to share with more artists from Latin America, especially for those that are starting right now?
Well, I will agree with there. I will say that even in the bad times, we have to put the good in us, you know. I think even when people are down because the pandemic or whatever, everybody need music, you know. So as we have to share our art in a new way, you know, maybe not live, but through the internet, through different ways. You have to reinvent yourself at this time, you know. And I think even myself, I learned so many things. I've been teaching for 30 years, you know, and suddenly I'm teaching online. And so, you know, it's like open your eyes and your ear and be open to new ideas. And, you know, since we're talking about this music from other places, it's a good moment to learn music from other, you know, Dominican Republic, Colombia, you know, Bolivia, Argentina. I just love to learn music from every part.
Yeah, and well, fortunately, I've noticed, I mean, I love Latin American music in general, but doing this exercise helped me to understand a lot better that we are not so different, and that we actually, we have so many common, good common things, also some other things that have us in the situation that we are right now, but we have so many beautiful things that we actually can do music together, but many other things together, to art in general and good things together. Daryl, what would you like to say to, well, actually you already said that. Ciao, cortamos. Well, so this is our last song, and we choose two different songs that are related to the same thematic, and I would love for you to present it. So the first one is the first one.
Gloria Incompleta.
So you talk first. Yeah? Like, tú haces la de la Gloria Incompleta y tú haces la de...
Okay.
No, ¿sí? Okay. So, yeah. Would you guys like to introduce us to our Puerto Rican medley?
Sure, I'll be happy to start with the first one, Gloria Incompleta. It's a song, I'm not really sure who composed it, but it was popularized by Daniel Santos, which is one of my favorite singers in you know, from Puerto Rico. It talks about his sentiment of you know, wanting Puerto Rico to be independent, to be a sovereign country. And it's a hell of a song. Mm-hmm.
Well, and the next one?
The next one is called Soñando con Puerto Rico from the composer Bobby Capó. And this song became famous. He wrote it in the 60s when he was living in New York. Most of those, I want you to understand, those compositions are people, the nostalgic, when you are out from your country, you know, and you have this nostalgia that you want to come back and you have those memories. And so you honor those things. So, you know, this beautiful song, because he's talking about his dream to be in Puerto Rico. What does it mean to be there when you are far away and you want to come back to the land that you was born, the land that you smell there, you see the beaches, and you know, it's a lot of poetry. But the good thing about this composer, Bobby Capó, to me important, is that he will mix beautiful lyrics with amazing melodies. One of my favorite composer.
Well, so let's enjoy our songs. Again, thank you so much for being here tonight. And with these beautiful boleros, La Gloria Incompleta and Soñando con Puerto Rico, we say good night today. Thank you.
Hi, thank you.
Ciao, ciao.
La gloria le ha sido incompleta a mi pobre bandera, y en su aparición tendrá que tener compañera camino a la meta de liberación. Se oirán las cadencias de un himno que un pueblo respeta, respetando a dos. ¡Oh, soledad!
¡Soledad!
Apague el sol, pero viva mi
ambición.
Preciosa y gloriosa, cual madre celosa, cuidando a sus hijos con el corazón. Las cadencias de un himno que un pueblo respeta, respetando a dos. ¡Oh! Soledad,
soledad,
cuánto ahora vales. Que arrasen los mares, se hundan la tierra, se rompan los cielos, que se apague el sol. Pero viva mi ambición.
Viva mi ambición.
Celosa, cuidando a sus hijos con el corazón. Que te acaricia la brisa y sientes que el rocío mañanero besa tiernamente tu mejilla y el aroma del café te hace cosquillas. Seguro sueñas que estás en Puerto Rico. Si por casualidad duermes sueña que te enamoran las olas y que hay un cielo azul, él conjura con la luna para hacerte prisionero. No lo digo porque es la tierra que quiero. Seguro sueñas que estás en Puerto Rico. Duermo y notas que una lágrima me brota. Seguramente es que yo sueño que camino por las calles de mi pueblo y en el dulce río aquel de mil recuerdos que viví el ayer, quizás llorando.
cabeza cuape, sento talas vine in occhia te. I cintiliato ci pizzane, calo ci occhie tu punti. Spicchi un te si smetto transcal, hashihal ci aietton cusu male.
Voz de la guitarra mía. Al despertar en la mañana, quiero cantar la alegría de mi tierra mexicana.
Mutilado de esperanza y de razón, tengo un corazón que no atrapa su cordura. Ay, 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 este corazón se desnuda de impaciencia ante tu voz. Pobre corazón que no atrapa su.
La gloria le ha sido incompleta a mi pobre bandera, y en su aparición tendrá que tener compañera camino a la meta de liberación. Se oirán las cadencias de un himno que un pueblo respeta, respetando a dos.